Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you my newest brush from APShaveCo from Canada. A little pause for the thumbnail. So this is a synthetic brush, as you can see. It has the Silksmoke synthetic hair bristle knot in it. It is 24 millimeters, and the size, the full size of the brush is small or smaller than my Yaki. As you can see, this is my Yaki. This is the APShave. It's smaller, but it has this nice curve in here, and it's very good to hold it. It's not uncomfortable, to my opinion. And this has the Blue Lagoon handle. It's got some nice swirls in it. I believe this company, APShaveCo from Canada, they only glue the knots to the handles. I don't know if they make the knots or the handles. I believe they don't make either of them, and they only sell them, but at a very cheap price and very small shipping fees all the way from Canada, it's no-brainer. This was 17 euros for the brass and approximately 8 euros from the shipping. It was 25 euros combined, and it only took 7 days to reach Greece from Canada. And the total length, let me talk about some dimensions. The total length is 10 centimeters or 4 inches, the total. The handle is 4 centimeters or 1.7 inches. The loft is 5 centimeters or 2 inches. The dimensions are approximately the numbers that I am telling you. And the diameter of the handle is 3.5 centimeters or 1.5 inches, and the weight of the razor is 60 grams or 2 ounces approximately. It's a small brush. The handle is smaller than the knot, as you can see, and it's got a nice backbone, but with softer tips than the tuxedo. I had some test lathers in it, and I had only one or two shaves. It's new brush, fresh brush to me, and it's still breaking in. When I first got it, it was a little bit mashed together like this. It was not blooming, and I feel that it's starting to spread a little bit now. So I'm gonna use it and review it today for you. Also, this company, the APShave, has some other handles, butterscotch, like fox marble style, and has an innovative design. They have the handle, and all the knots are interchangeable. I believe that's the word. And you just the knot is glued with in a small piece of plastic, and this screws on top of the handle, so you can have one handle, and then you just unscrew the knot, put a different knot, and so on. And they have this knot, they have a tuxedo knot like this, or something like this. They have also a Sinbad knot, also a synthetic, a cashmere knot. They have some flat top, I believe this is a bulb fan hybrid type of style, and they have also some badger knots. So for the rest of my shaving gear, the Q Κερκίνη, Bergamot and Meat Shaving Soap with Buffalo Milk. The Qshave adjustable, but I'm gonna use it a little bit different. If you saw my cleaning tutorial for this razor, you could see that there is a proper way to reassemble your razor. If you assemble the base plate, the plate that the, your blade sits, if you assemble it in a wrong way, you could make your razor pretty aggressive. Then there was something like you could turn the dial all the way after 6, and you could save with it like it was setting number 1 or 2 or something like that. So today I'm gonna use it on setting number 4. I have 1 day of growth, and I'm gonna dial down after the second pass on the number 3. And to mention that I had, let me soak my brass. Sorry for the sink, some hair fell out. For me saving, not from the brass. And I had lost a few hair from it. 5, 6, 7. A small amount, nothing big, important. And I'm gonna load straight from it. And I had the opportunity to save with the wrong settings on my Qshave for a couple of times, but then I read it about this online, and I didn't know what's the proper way to some more water to my brass. To reassemble your Qshave, I thought it was a bigger gap because it's aggressive razor, it has a bigger gap and so on. But then some wet savers from Badger and Blade, I believe, this was a forum, said that it was when you fully assemble and you fully tighten your razor, you should make the base plate touch the blade tray, touch the base plate, and this is what I did. And when I did this, I immediately felt that it was a whole new razor, and it was so much smooth, efficient, but not so aggressive like it used to be. Some water here. I'm gonna use some pre-save cream, some Proraso. Proraso green as a pre-save. Let me put a little. I don't know if you can hear it, there is some workers, there's a construction site near my house. So I'm gonna take some foam that it was created by the soap, by the loading process. This soap has mint, and it cools your skin, but without the side effects of the menthol that gets irritated or irritating for some people. This is a more sensitive version of a mentholated soap. So the lather directly on my face. I tend to load these soaps extra heavy, so soft tips, so soft, and then add the water like this, like another Australian YouTuber and wet shaver does. He takes water and it's just adding water until it's clear from his skin. I will add a little bit more and then makes a lather like this. And this is really easy to do. If you load it too much soap and it's really thick and pasty and you have to add a lot of water every time, a swirl and water and swirl and water, and this is really easy to do if you have something like that, because as you can see I have plenty of lather of good created lather and not some raw soap, and you can also put some more water and make it a little bit thinner or keep working it in and make it a little bit thicker, whatever you want, whatever you like. This is your time. I believe it's pretty good for me like this. Really cool sensation for the menthol. Let me clean a little bit my neck and my sideburns here and there. I believe it's pretty good. So I have in my razor a Polsilver blade on its fourth use, fourth setting. It's appropriate. So, first pass with the grain. Don't worry, Johnny. If you can see me, or if you see my or this video, I should say, I'm not forgotten you. I will do the setting C6 shave with this razor. I said to him in a friendly manner to that I will grow a full beard and then use it on 6, but it's not so difficult after all, because I had in my mind that the 6 is, it's the after 6 setting, and I believe 12. Oh my god, it's very very big. I can see you and I can show you, this is the number 6 setting. As you can see, a lot of blade gap. If you press this with your, let me press it here, and you turn it all the way the other direction, you can turn it here, and this is the 6, the 12, a full rotation. This is a scary setting to shave with. This is for men, but I will not take that risk, and I'm gonna save it like the Qshave manufacturer used to want to save. It's a little bit tagging on this area because my growth is thicker and denser, but it's not so uncomfortable. And be very careful when you readjust. You should take your hands, dry them, and then readjust your razor, because it's very... you probably cut your fingers because you slip the razor, and you cut your fingers when you do this motion with your... Maybe this form setting is a little bit aggressive for my regular shaves and my everyday shaves. But it's not so uncomfortable. You have to use a lighter touch and pay more attention. I should clean this area of my nose. So, perfect. I'm gonna dial it down to 3. Some water on my face. Then reapply the soap. Some painting motions. I believe I don't have any cuts or whippers. And then all of a sudden, in your lather, there is a whipper, a wild whipper appearing. So far, no whippers. Thank you, God. How many days of growth should I grow to be able to use the Qshave on number 6? So sorry, some sore neck. Next pass. Across the grain, setting number 3. Nice pass. And that thing in the handle, that mark, makes it very grippy and very good to hold it from there. The third setting is very good. Almost no touch-ups, a little bit here and some here, some there. Regular spots for me some red dots here and there, some water. I'm gonna dial it down to 2. Do something like an adjusting grain pass. More soap. My aftershave gonna stink very bad because I do something like across the grain and I can't handle it very good, or I'm not used to it like other people. It's almost BBS. Some follicles that I'm feeling now, it's gone now. Be a little bit hidden after a couple of hours because they're gonna dry out. So I'm gonna rinse my face and get back to you for the aftershave in a minute. So have some red spots here and there because of the adjusting grain pass. I'm gonna apply some Epsilon aftershave blue Mediterranean. It stinks, but not so bad. It's probably the menthol. Not probably. Most of this stink is the menthol, because every time I apply this aftershave, it makes my skin a little bit tingling, or a lot tingling. But so nice cooling sensation. Got some whippers. I don't know, it's all my fault. It's not the razors or the brush fault or the blade fault. So thank you for very much for sticking out. Please like, subscribe and comment below. And have a nice day. Goodbye and take care. Goodbye.